All right, we're gonna wait till a few people maybe signs on. Can you tell me if they're signing on or not? Amen. We'll get started in just a second or two, all right? Just a second. My grandbabies are smiling at me. Amen. Anybody on there yet?
Mm-mm.
All right.
You got some coming.
Well, we want to greet you in the name of Jesus. Amen. It is good to be in the Lord's house this morning. I tell you, it's nothing like, amen, the sunrise service, amen, at your local church. And they've been probably 30 years or better, amen, that probably close to 40 years. I've never missed a sunrise service, far as I know of, and God's good, amen. Didn't want to start this morning. I want to say I appreciate the church tuning in. Just sign in, church, if you would, and let us know during the sermon that you're there. It'll help you, Pastor. Remember that we go live at 11 o'clock this morning for the regular Sunday Easter service. We'll be having singing and preaching, and then again this evening at 6 p.m. So we want to just greet you in the name of the Lord. And those that, besides the church that sign in and listen to us, we want to say we appreciate you that tuned in faithfully. But you pray for us this morning as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Let's bow our heads. We'll go to the Lord in prayer. Amen. And then we'll get right into some singing. Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, for the privilege to pray. God, the opportunity to be back in your house, dear Lord, live this morning, dear God, to celebrate the resurrection. God, thank you, God, for this sunrise service. We ask, Lord, that the songs that are sang, God, you'd be magnified, you'd be lifted up, God, you'd be glorified. We ask, dear Heavenly Father, that you'd bless dear Father in the preaching there. God, that souls, God, would be saved even through the live streaming. And God, I pray, dear Heavenly Father, that God, that you'd just touch that heart, God, that's discouraged. Lord, strengthen that when it's weak. We'll give you glory. God, we'll give you honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. All right. We're going to song this morning, so you pray for us as we try, all right? When Mary saw Jesus in the garden so soon, she thought he was the keeper who watched o'er the tomb. But she knew it was Jesus when she turned to say, "Go tell my disciples I'm risen today." Early one morning at the breaking of dawn, two women went out to the garden alone. They were going to anoint Jesus with spices that day, but Jesus had risen, the stone rolled away. Jesus was gone. He ran to the garden and John came along. But the tomb, it was empty, that marvelous grace. For today, the napkin that covered his face. When Peter stooped over to look in the tomb, two angels were sitting in that little room. Why seek ye the living among the dead? For Jesus had risen, the angel then said. Early one morning at the breaking of dawn, two women went out to the garden alone. They were going to anoint Jesus with spices that day, but Jesus had risen, the stone rolled away. Well, thank the Lord. Amen. What a blessing. Amen. The stone, the tomb is empty. The stone was rolled away. Well, we was practicing on you this morning just a little bit. You pray for my mom as she sings you a song this morning. She's not missed maybe the year that you had you that you had failed, you'd missed that Easter morning. But anyway, you pray for her and lift her up as she sings this song. Sitting in the congregation, she's wanting to holler amen, I think, or something in her own way, amen. But you pray for my grandbabies as they sing. I want to say it's good to have my mom with me this morning, and amen. I think it was last year she had to miss due to was it last year? The year before? I think it was 2 years ago. But anyway, good to have her, amen, singing. So you pray for her. My family, you lift them up to the Lord, amen, as they sing. So let me hand the microphone off, amen.
Borrowed a coat.
We hope and pray that you enjoyed that. Appreciate my family this morning helping us out. Far as the audio, it was me. I was on when I went back. But anyway, aren't you glad? The only thing you bought was me. Savannah, if you will, just turn that camera back where it needs to be. I tilted it just a tad. But thank God for this resurrection morning. Amen. I noticed we had several signed on, but continue, amen, to sign on. Amen. And comment, amen, during the services. Let us know you're there. Now, there have been people that say that they watch it. They've told me this week, amen, that they have watched the broadcast or the live streaming. They may not have commented, but we want to say we appreciate those. And if you don't normally comment, just punch in there, your family's watching. It'll be a blessing to us, all right? If you got your Bibles, amen, this morning, I would like for you to turn to the book of Matthew, chapter 28. Matthew, chapter 28, this morning, by the help of the Lord, we'll bring to you a message that I felt like God had laid upon her heart. Amen. All right, then. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we ask that you bless the reading, God, of the Scripture. We ask, Lord, that you bless, God, the Word of God. We know that you said in thy Word that it would not, Lord, return void. We thank you, God, for this resurrection morning. We thank you, God, that you are alive. And God, that you're not in the tomb. God, you're not in the grave. But God, you're seated at the right hand of the Father. Lord, to make intercession, God, for me, dear God, and us. Lord, I love you. I thank you, dear God, that you would just have your way now. God, speak to the hearts of the people this morning, those that's gathered around their phone or their laptop, computer, TV. Dear Father, I pray in Jesus' name, God, that you would, Lord, just be with them. God, give us the good unction of the Holy Ghost, dear God, to preach, God, the services today. We ask, dear God, if there's any under the sound of our voice that don't know you in the free pardon of sin, God, we pray this day would be the day, this hour would be the hour they would come to know you, Lord, in Jesus' name. We'll give you glory, we'll give you honor, and we'll give you praise in Christ's name. Amen and amen. All right. The Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 28, begin reading in verse number 1, in the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulcher. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. And the angel answered and said unto the women, fear not ye, for I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said. Come see the place where the Lord lay, and go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall you see him. Lo, I have told you. Now let me ask my family, amen, that's in the congregation, amen, this morning, amen, to back us, amen, as they can. And you at home, you back us, amen. You say amen and do it on the live Facebook, all right? As I begin to think, God began to deal my heart, amen, yesterday evening. Of course, the message, amen, of the resurrection, amen, is never changed. Amen. The message of the resurrection is always the same message. God does allow us, amen, to get different thoughts. Amen. I thank God for the nuggets that God gives us, amen, in his precious word. But just by the way of introduction, amen, this morning, there are many messages, amen, that can be preached. And there's many messages that can be shouted out to a lost and dying world. But there's only one, amen, that is truly worthy of being proclaimed, amen. In Psalm 22, amen, the Bible teaches us, you can see the anguish, amen, and the humiliation and suffering, amen, of the cross of Christ and the price, amen, that was paid for mine and your sin, amen. But we can learn how to live our lives, amen, by Jesus' resurrection, by the resurrection of our Lord. I mean, so that this message that is the greatest message can grow louder and, amen, in and through our lives. The greatest message ever and ever will be proclaimed and shouted is He's alive. Amen. That's the greatest message, amen, that could ever be proclaimed, is that He is, amen, alive. Amen. Listen, number one, just my introduction. What other message is there worthy of shouting about? And what other message is there worth, amen, giving God glory and shouting, amen, and worthy to praise Him? Listen, Acts 4:12 said, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Amen. What other message, amen, is there worth shouting about? Amen. Telling. Amen. What is that message, preacher? That message is He's alive. Amen. Hey, thank God. Thank God. Amen. We serve a risen Savior. Amen. That message is the good news. That message is, amen, the gospel. Amen. Of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. That gospel is, amen, the truth. He said, I am the way. Amen. The truth and the life. Amen. Listen, that is the gospel. Isaiah said it. Amen. Best. Amen. To lift up your voice like a trumpet. Amen. And spare not. Amen. We're to lift up our voice. And thank God this morning I have, amen, a message. Amen. It's a message that, amen, Christ lives. Amen. Jesus, amen, He arose. Amen. He is not here, for He is risen. Amen. It's the message that the world hates. The world don't like that message. Amen. The world hates that message. Amen. But listen, it's the message that has set the captive free. Thank God. Thank God. Amen. Because He lives, we can live also. Amen. Not only that. Amen. But number two in the introduction, the only one that that could give everlasting life. Listen, think about this. The only one that could give everlasting life. Amen. Was crucified. Amen. Was beat. Was battered. Amen. He was taken, amen, to the whipping post. Amen. The cat of nine tails, amen, that were planted together. Amen. And He, amen, was beat. Amen. Hey, you listen to this preacher. He is mocked. They placed a crown of thorns on His head. Put a purple robe on Him. Amen. Give Him a reed to place in His hand. He was a, hey, I'm talking about the only one that could give eternal life. Amen. Was spat upon. He was humiliated. Amen. He was buried in a borrowed tomb. But I'm thankful that the story don't stop there. Amen. Listen, it don't end there. Amen. What are you saying, preacher? Number three, amen, He got up. Amen. Amen. Matthew 28:6, He is not here, for He is risen. Amen. Thank God. Thank God we serve. Amen. A risen Savior. I'm glad He got up. Oh, the old saying goes, you can't keep a good man down. Well, let me just say, the Christian, amen, amen, saying to that would be, you can't keep the God man down. Hallelujah. Thank God. Amen. Listen, I'm telling you, because no grave could hold Him, amen, there's no grave one day can hold this old body down. I'm glad, thank God, there ain't no grave. If you're born again, your name's written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Amen. Thank God you have eternal life. You have everlasting life. And thank God that, hey, the grave can't hold this old body down.
Amen.
Why? Because He got up. Thank God He got up. Death couldn't hold Him. Amen. I was thinking about it last night. Death couldn't hold Him. The stone couldn't seal Him. The grave clothes couldn't bind Him. The guards couldn't stop Him. Why? Because He got up. Amen. And the greatest message ever proclaimed. Amen. Amen. To this world. Amen. Is that Jesus lives. Amen. He is alive.
Amen.
I want you to notice, amen, four words in verses number 6 and verses number 7. There's four words I want to hit on just real quickly this morning. The word come, see, go, and tell. These were the directions the angels gave the women there in Matthew, amen, 28, verse 6 and 7, when they came early, amen, to the tomb that morning. Listen now to them. Let's listen to them one more time. Matthew 28,
Verse number 6 and 7, he is not here, for he is risen, as he said, come, see the place where the Lord lay, and go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he goeth before you into Galilee. There ye shall ye see him. Lo, I have told you. So you say, preacher, what are you saying this morning? Oh, and by the way, just to make the devil mad, amen, the stone wasn't rolled away to let our Savior out. Amen. Listen, it was moved to let you in. It was moved to let me and you in. Hey, the message of the resurrection. I believe there's a message. Amen. That's the title of the sermon this morning. Amen. The message of the resurrection, or what we can learn and see. Amen. That God wants to tell us. Amen. And allow us, amen, to participate in the resurrection this morning. What is the message? Number one, amen, it is come. Amen. He is not here, for he is risen, as he said, come. Oh, you say, preacher, what is that? It's a word. The word come is a word of invitation. Aren't you thankful? Thank God one day I got an invitation. Thank God one day, hallelujah, I got a call. I got an invite. Thank God there was a bidding, amen, in my soul. There was a bidding, amen, in my heart. It was an invitation, amen, to come, amen, to the waters of life. It was an invitation, amen, to come, hallelujah, and I could receive that water of life freely, amen. And thank God I got an invitation one day. How many could witness out there that one day you got an invitation one day? And thank God there was a bidding. Thank God there was a drawing. Thank God there was a call. And it was to come. Amen. Matthew 11, 28 and 9, 29. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. Listen, a lot of things, amen, could have kept the women that morning, amen, from coming to the tomb. Did you know that? There's a lot of things that could have kept them, amen, from coming, them women to coming to the tomb. Listen, I'm glad, amen. You said, preacher, what are they? Amen. Listen, fear could have kept them from coming, amen, to the tomb that day. What do you mean fear? I tell you, a cemetery, amen, hey, there's a little bit different atmosphere of a nighttime, amen, or of an early morning, amen, when you go into a cemetery. Fear could have overwhelmed their heart. Amen. It could have kept them back, but it didn't. Not only that, listen, they was looking for a corpse. But listen, when they walked up at the tomb that morning, amen, to arrive, amen, listen, they saw the stone rolled away. Amen, they was going to anoint the body of Jesus, amen, that morning. Amen, listen, they went for a corpse. Amen, but the corpse wasn't there. Amen, listen, a corpse, amen, that's a scary thing. But listen, the guards could have, hey, by fear of the guards, amen, could have kept them from going to the tomb that day. Amen, probably those guards were armed. Amen, they were there, amen. After they sealed, amen, the grave. Amen, but listen, but the love and compassion that they had, amen, would not stop them. Amen, they didn't let fear stop them that morning. They didn't let, amen, listen, hallelujah, the actions, and they didn't let, amen, the events of that morning, amen, keep them from going. They didn't let the fear of the guards there, amen, keeping watch, amen, stop them. I'm talking about the uncertainty, the questions that they had. Amen. Listen, I'm glad although in life we might have fears, although in life we might have uncertainty, and we're certainly living in some uncertain times. Amen. In this life we have questions, but I'm thankful Jesus never says, don't bother me. I'm glad Jesus never says, I'm too busy. Amen. Listen, his message is always come. Amen. Come. Amen. He invited, amen, many. Amen, through his ministry. He invited many, amen, through the word of God to come to him. He invites the little children, amen, to come to him. Amen. He teaches us in the word of God that we're to come as a little child. Amen. To come in that humility and to humble ourselves. He invited many, amen, to walk with him. He invited many, amen, to follow him. Listen, aren't you glad that God allows us and gives us an invitation to come to him personally? I'm glad he gave me an opportunity, amen, an invitation to come to him personally one day. I'm glad I felt a call. I'm glad I felt, amen, hallelujah, that bidding, amen, to come to him in salvation. Thank God one day the Holy Spirit, amen, convicted me of my sin. Oh, thank God for the call. Thank God we can go. Thank God we can come, amen, to the Lord Jesus Christ. You know what? The empty tomb not only invited Mary Magdalene and the other Mary into the tomb, but that empty tomb invites all of humanity. It invites all of humanity. Amen. That stone was rolled away. Amen. That stone, amen, was moved. Amen. And it invites you, church. It invites, amen, the world. It invites your family. It invites your friend and your neighbor. Amen. All of humanity saying, come. That empty tomb invites, amen, saying, come unto me. Amen. That empty tomb, I'm talking about all that shall call upon the name of the Lord. Amen. The Bible says, shall be saved. Aren't you thankful? Amen. That we can come.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm talking about the message of the resurrection. Verse number 6, he is not here, for he's risen, as he said, come. Then it said, see the place where the Lord lay. Number 2, the word see. Listen. If come, amen, you listen to the preacher this morning, amen, come, amen, it gives us a word of invitation. See, amen, means to perceive. It means to understand. It means to experience, amen, or encounter. Oh, you listen, the angel, amen, said, come and see the place. Oh, my, where the Lord lay. Amen, in other words, come and understand. Amen. Get a better understanding. In other words, amen. Hey, that Jesus wasn't there. Amen. Come and get an experience. Hey, you want to say thank God one day? Amen. I'm glad he opened up my blinded eyes. Hallelujah. Amen. Like the old prodigal. Amen. Amen. The Bible says, amen, while he's down there in the hog pen. Amen. Hey, he came to himself. Amen. What does that mean, preacher? It means really, amen, that he saw. Amen. He the Father's house. Amen. Thank God one day I, amen, experienced. Say, thank God I got an experience. Amen. Amen. And I'm glad that God got a hold of me. Amen. My family was singing that the other day. Amen. Out here in the drive-in service. Amen. I looked over. Amen. And my dog, my little granddaughter, Tori, amen, was there in the car. And as I saying, something got a hold of me. I seen her little hand come out the car window. Amen. She was praising the Lord. Hey! You say, why, preacher? Hey, I believe, amen. Hey, her eye, open her eyes that day. Amen. What date was that? May what?
May
14th, 2018. At the Autumn Care Nursing Home. And they had sung that song that night. Something got a hold of me. Amen. You know what happened? Amen. Listen, they came to me. My little granddaughter was in the next, amen, little old room there. Amen. Or a big room. Amen. It's a cafeteria. It's another section. And said she wanted to be saved. You talk about tearfully calling upon the name of the Lord. You say, preacher, what happened to that little girl? What happened? Amen. Oh, on May 14th, amen, I tell you what happened. Amen, my little granddaughter, amen, she perceived, amen, she understood. Hey, you listen, she experienced that day. She encountered that day of the convicting hand of the Lord Jesus Christ, and she gave her heart to the Lord. Aren't you glad, church? Amen, you can come and see. You know what? To see means to investigate. What do you mean to investigate? Amen. You don't say come and see if you have something to hide. Amen. You don't say come and see if you have something to hide. Creese, hey, you say it. Amen. You say come and see if you have something to show or if you have something to tell others about. Listen, Christianity, amen, has nothing to hide. I want you to know this morning, Jesus is real. Jesus is alive. He's well this morning. Amen. Hey, Jesus is sitting at the right hand of the Father. Amen. He ain't worried about this world's economy. He ain't worried about, amen, this pandemic. I want you to know, amen, he's God. He always will be God. He's almighty. Amen. He's real. He's alive. Hey, listen. We serve a risen Savior. Now, listen. I said Christianity has nothing to hide. But now Buddhism, it has something to hide. Islam, amen, has something to hide. Mormonism has something to hide. You say, preacher, you're getting on all of these different religions. Let me say this. Buddha is still in the grave. Muhammad is still in the grave. Joseph Smith is still in the grave. What are you saying, preacher? Amen. The tomb of that empty tomb, amen. Hey, we see Jesus Christ is alive. I don't serve a dead God this morning. Hey, you say, preacher, oh, you God's just religion. I got news for you. Amen. I've got the way, the truth, and the life. Amen, Jesus. You say, preacher, hey, you ain't never seen an empty tomb. I may have not have seen it with my eyes. Hey, but thank God spiritually. Amen. I saw. Hallelujah. Why? Because I came to Him one day in faith, believing. And thank God. Amen. Hey, my eyes were open. And thank God, the empty tomb, Jesus is alive. The angel wanted the women to see nothing. What do you mean, preacher? Why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, for he is risen. Thank God, one day he opened my blinded eyes. I had a Damascus Roads experience one day. Hallelujah. What? I might not have had that great light like, amen, Saul had, amen, came upon him that day. Amen. But thank God I had a light from heaven. Amen. I might not have seen it visibly, but thank God I seen it spiritually. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank God I saw the light. I'm talking about the message of the resurrection. Come and see the place where Jesus lay. Amen. Amen. Where the Lord lay. Thirdly, let me say this. And I'll use the third point to use two of the words. And the Bible says there in verse number 7, it says, and go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. And go quickly and tell his disciples that he is risen from the dead. I want to thank God we can come and we can see, but don't stay at the empty tomb. Hey, thank God we can come and see, but don't stay at the empty tomb. Thank God we can visit there. Amen. The angel wanted the women's experience that day at that empty tomb to become a declaration. Amen. To become, hey, you listen to this, preacher, a declaration. The message, I'm talking about not a message. I'm talking about the message. Listen, we don't have good news. We have great news. Amen. Hallelujah. We have the best news. What is it, preacher? He lives. Amen. And he is alive. You know what the empty tomb does? Angel, you come to the piano. You know what the empty tomb does? I'm glad it forgives. That because of the empty tomb, amen, we have forgiveness in the Lord Jesus Christ. I thank God that empty tomb, the message of the empty tomb teaches us, amen, amen, that there is a way of repentance. Amen, thank God that empty tomb regenerates. Amen, I'm glad it makes new. I'm glad it makes alive. That empty tomb cleanses. Amen, the empty tomb washes. Amen, thank God. What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Amen. And through the death and burial and resurrection of our Savior. Thank God the empty tomb satisfies. Thank God the empty tomb fills. What are they more important to talk about? What are they more important to talk about? Don't be ashamed of the message of the resurrection. Now, I heard a little story, and I'm going to close on this. Now, if my sources are right, you pay attention to this, you're going to miss it. They say that 22 years after Abraham Lincoln died, there was a rumor spread that his body was not in the grave. It happened again after another 17 years had passed. So one day they dug up his coffin. And you know what? The body was still there. The witnesses, amen, that done that did four things. They came, they saw, they went, and they told. See, rumors spread about the body of Christ after his death. You said, preacher, what do you mean? They said, hey, just come and say that the soul, that somebody came and took the body away. But see, this time it was right. Not because his body was stolen, but because he got up. Let me tell you something, friend. Thank God he got up. Thank God he is alive this morning. I want us to close by this. Jesus is the only one who rose from the dead. Lincoln can't help you. Amen. Abraham Lincoln can't help you. Amen. Buddha can't help you. Muhammad. Amen. Joseph Smith. I'm telling you this morning, amen, Jesus is the only one, amen, that rose from the dead and has power to change lives, amen. I'm talking about the message of the resurrection. Come, see, go, tell, amen. What do you mean, preacher? We need to go tell somebody, amen, what Jesus has done for you and that you serve a risen Savior. I'd like for every head to be bowed. I'm going to let my wife sing a song. Amen. You lift her up. Can you get her in it? Amen. And listen, church, you that are listening out there by Facebook. Amen. Listen, let me just say this, Facebook friends. Go ahead. If you don't know Jesus in the free pardon of sin, call on him. Maybe church, Christian, you can get down beside your couch. Get down beside your kitchen table, beside the TV. And say, thank you, Lord, that I serve a risen Savior. Oh, if you don't know him for you, just come and see. If God's helping you this morning, confess it, claim it.
Yes, Jesus.
Ever breaking up that door.
for the message of the resurrection. We don't have good news. We have great news. We have the best news. He's alive. He's alive. Church, I love you. I appreciate you tuning in this morning. God bless you for that. I know we've had comment through Facebook Live about how people give. We don't have a direct online giving, amen, on our website. But you can send it to Post Office Box 516 Marion, North Carolina. You can do that. The members of the church, amen, we can come by. We can make arrangements to come by and pick yours up. Amen. Somebody said, preacher, you're getting no money. The bills still have to be paid. Amen. And we want to say I appreciate all that's tuned in today. Remember now at 11 o'clock, we're going back live here at the church. Now, we didn't have the drive-in service this morning, although I wished we had now. Amen. But they were calling. I'm glad the Bible, amen, Jesus said in the book of Nahum that he has his way in the whirlwind and in the storm. Amen. We just didn't know what the morning was going to hold. But thank God I can feel his presence and we can serve the resurrection even here. Amen. Thank God that you've tuned in. 11 o'clock. Please share this. Please like this. And please comment. It'll help other people. All right. We love you. God bless you. And we'll see you at 11 o'clock.